You're not going to want to miss this episode of The AI Show, coming to you, because it's special, from Microsoft Ignite. Francesco Lazzari tells us all about the difference between machine learning, deep learning, and what it means for AI. We'll see you then. Hello and welcome to this special edition of the AI Show, where we're live. Well, we're not live because you're watching a recording, but we're live right now at Ignite, and I have my esteemed dear colleague, Francesco Lazzari. We actually work together, but she's much classier than I am. How are you doing, Francesca?
I'm good. I'm great. And thank you so much for having me on the AI Show.
Fantastic. Well, look, one of the things we're going to talk about, because we like to keep these very crisp, is machine learning, deep learning. What's the difference? And we were hoping you could help us out.
Yes, so this is a great question, okay, because actually all customers I have been working with ask me the same question. Okay, we want to do something with our data. We want to use our data to answer our business questions, but how can we use machine learning? And what's the difference between the machine learning, deep learning? What is AI? So I wrote an article about this, so I can give them, you know, an answer every time they ask me this question. And this article really compared the three different areas. So let's start with the central one, okay, with the core one, which is machine learning.
Okay.
So I think about machine learning as a portfolio of algorithms. You have to think about algorithms as statistical functions, mm-hmm, mathematical functions that use your data to learn something and give you a result. Now, what is AI? AI is about consuming the machine learning. So you build the application on top of machine learning models,
okay,
and you consume these machine learning models, these AI application over time. So it's a really intelligent way of consuming machine learning models that are reading your data. Then deep learning. Deep learning is just a type of machine learning. It's a very interesting type of machine learning because it's based on what we call the neural networks. So there are many different networks, and since we have different networks, different layers also as well,
okay,
they are called deep learning. But it's just a type, it's just a typology of machine learning. So you don't have to think about machine learning as and deep learning as something that, you know, they are like completely different.
Okay.
They are in the same area, and AI, of course, is using both of them.
I see. So machine learning then is a discipline whereby we extract information or algorithms from data, I think, yeah, is kind of what you said. And deep learning is a subset of that that has special kinds of algorithms.
Yes.
So at what point can I be like, I am using deep learning? How,
yeah,
do you know when you're there?
So you are there when, of course, it depends a lot on the type of data that you have,
uh-huh,
the type of questions that you want to answer.
Right.
And if you have, for example, a huge amount of data, so also from a hardware perspective, you need, for example, to use GPUs instead of CPUs. I would say these are all indicators that tells you that you are entering the deep learning area.
That's fantastic.
Of course, in terms of also of different APIs that you can use in order to facilitate your deep learning work, there are so many different, and you can use all of them on Azure, like TensorFlow,
right,
Keras, and so there is really, it's really up to you and on the type of data and the type of question that you are using. Another interesting part is that there are multiple types of neural networks.
Yeah.
So this means many different type of deep learning algorithms. There are convolutional neural networks,
which I like. I'm a vision guy, so I like those.
Recurrent neural networks,
which I'm trying to understand. So
yeah,
you're going to help us out, maybe.
Of course.
Yeah.
And then under recurrent neural networks, for example, we have LSTM
and
GRU. Exactly. Yep. And they are very good with the sequential type of data. So for time series scenarios, when you want to build the hand-to-hand time series forecasting solution, LSTM can be very, very helpful. But
right,
again, it depends a lot on the problem that you want to solve, on the size of your data, on the type of data that you want, and then, of course, how you're going to build this hand-to-hand architecture.
Awesome. So it turns out that all of this stuff she wrote down, and she didn't write it down in just any place. She wrote it down in our docs. So why don't you tell us about this doc that she wrote and how people can go and learn
more? Yes, so this is a very nice doc because you you can consume it in a very nice and easy way, in the sense that we didn't put too much information, but we just selected the most important information. So the doc starts with the main difference between artificial intelligence, machine learning, and deep learning. It explains everything here. And then if you keep on, we created this very nice table that compares machine learning versus deep learning in terms of number of data points. This is exactly the question that you were asking. Hardware dependencies, futurization process, because for example with machine learning you need to do what we call the feature engineering. You need to get your data set bigger, richer by doing feature engineering. With deep learning you don't need to. So there are some differences also for this learning approach, execute time, and then of course the output. So this is a nice simple table that compares the two. And then if you keep scrolling, you can see that there are different type of explanation for deep learning. What you can do with deep learning. For example, there is the name entity recognition use case, object detection use case, image caption generation, machine translation, text analytics. And then there is a short explanation of artificial neural networks. And we already mentioned some of them.
Right.
For a neural network, recurrent neural network, and convolutional neural network.
That's awesome.
So again, you can see that this is a very nice article that people can enjoy reading. And then at the end, you have also a lot of different resources on how you can do deep learning on Azure.
Awesome. So what we'll do is we'll make sure that this particular article is in the show notes so you can actually go and read it and get a sense for it. I actually love it. I'm a computer vision person. You obviously know all the things. Time series forecasting and sequence, and so I'd love to learn more about that. Thank you so much for spending some time with us. Thank you so much for watching and learning all about machine learning, deep learning, and AI, what it means, and a special doc. We'll put the link below. Again, thanks for watching this special episode of the AI Show coming to you from Ignite. We'll see you next time.